Dong Shema Hao. Welcome, everybody. It is the 28th of September. We're in class 18. I think we actually have only two more movement classes to go, and then we'll spend the rest of October in review, which is probably two classes in review, and then we'll start on the third section in this same slot. So let us begin with our fundamentals, with our standing practice, still practice. So we'll start feet parallel, a little bit wider than shoulder width. And let's begin in prepare. So legs straight but not locked. Feel the weight evenly on the heels and the balls of your feet, slightly more on the ball. We call that weight over the bubbling well. Crotch rounded. Now sink your tailbone down, sink your hips down, drop the shoulders, absorb the chest, lift the head. Now we'll go into pole stance. Absorb the legs, bend the legs, and let's start at the feet. Start with the footwork. So your feet are both pointing to the front. Make sure that you have your weight over the bubbling well. If it's easy to lift your balls of the feet or lift the heels, you are not even. So adjust your weight by adjusting at the front of the hip crease, and make sure that your crotch makes a nice arch, that your knees and toes are in a line. Call that crotch rounded. Now we'll do our posture checks, the four essentials for posture. One, pushing up the head. You're looking straight ahead, mouth naturally closed, your teeth gently touching, tongue on the top of your roof of your mouth, gently. And at the same time it's pushing up, also feel your head is suspended, your head is hooked onto the ceiling, and everything from the shoulders on down is just hanging like silk on a coat hanger. That will help you with number two, which is shoulders sinking, elbows dropping. So feel your shoulder blades dropping down behind your ribs. Feel your elbows heavy. Now absorb the chest and round the back. Do that by feeling that your elbows are pulling out at the shoulders, which pull out the spine. At the same time, the front half of this big circle from elbows to wrists to fingertips, nice circle, feels the extension there. So now we're extending left, right, like a bow, left, right, opening across our back. Now vertically drop your hips straight down. So this will mean that your lower back opens and extends. And feel that opening all the way to the top of your head. This is our posture, and our posture helps with our breathing. So as you breathe, notice your abdomen extending as you breathe in and shrinking as you breathe out. What we're trying to get to is the kind of breathing that you do if you're lying on your back and you're just letting everything go and your breath moves your stomach. Easy to do when you're lying down and much harder to do when you're standing up. So that's what we're practicing here. Even harder to do when you're moving. And so what we're trying to do when we do our moving practice is to keep this, what we call breathing flow, natural breathing, or if you want the jargon, sinking the qi into the dantian as we do our moving practice. Now we can do standing practice in many postures. We've done the standing posture, we've done empty stance. Since the movements we're working on at the moment are bow stance, let's do bow stance. Go into a bow stance, shift your weight to one side, open the other toe to the corner. I'll go back a little bit. Step out shoulder width. front foot straight, back foot to the corner. Drop your arms if you want. We're just going to quickly check our footwork. So you've got 60% on the front leg, 40% on the back, weight over the bubbling well. So even heel and ball, both front leg and back leg. Feel your crotch rounded, so your knees aren't tilted in. Your weight is straight down onto your feet. Your hip is centered. Imagine a line from your front foot, back heel. Tailbone is roughly between them. It's not out to the one side or out to the other side. Centralized. And then your torso is set in parallel with your back leg, or in the same angle as your back leg. So let's do this for a minute. So we're in this stance. Four posture checks. Head up. At the same time, shoulders sinking down, elbows down. Absorb the chest, round the back, and relax the waist. Here you're going to have to find it slightly different from when you're standing up straight, but the relative position of your spine and your hips will be the same, but your hips are tilted. What we want is these postures when we do the form as well. And so in the last 20 seconds, watch your breath. As you breathe in, see if you can notice your belly extending. As you breathe out, it contracts. Now let's change to the other side, shift your weight back, pick up the front foot, put it down 45 degrees at the back, shift onto that other foot, step out shoulder width, go forward. Again, let's just check the footwork. Shoulder width, front foot straight, back foot to corner. Feel the front leg is pushing backwards to help the back foot go down flat. The back leg is pushing forward to help the front foot go down. Crotch rounded, hips centralized, torso tilted forward. Here we go. 1 minute. Start with the hips this time. Relax the waist, so feel your lower back open and extended. And feel your head pushing up. So the front of your face is actually vertical. The pulling up of your head, even though your torso is tilted forward, your head is, the front of your face is vertical. As the head pulls up, feel the shoulders dropping down, elbows dropping down, and now absorb the chest. When we do the form today, we'll practice together in a minute. Pick one of these four and see, just notice as we practice the form together, how you are doing. If there are particular movements where your shoulders rise up or your head tilts forward too much. And in the last 20 seconds, let's just think about our breathing. Just let your posture help your abdomen open up and relax. Breathe in, it extends. Breathe out, it collapses, it contracts. Okay, we're going to change to the other side. Now we're going to do a few waist exercises. Last week we did the horizontal. Today we're going to do vertical, which means moving forward and back here. Be very gentle. If you don't do this every day, be very careful. Don't hurt yourself. But in your bow stance, move your lower back backwards and your chest back, and then move your chest forward. Back and forward. Back and forward. Back and forward. You're not moving your hips, you're just moving your chest. Shift to the back. You might find it comfortable to just open your hips a little bit more to the corner. And again, we're going to move forward and back. So forward, back, forward, back, forward, back, forward, back. And since we're at the back, let's change to the other side, into a bow stance. Start at the front. As you move your chest back, your chest is square, but move it along the line between your feet, because that's where your support is. So actually, your chest is moving diagonally forward and back. So forward, back, forward, back, forward, back, forward, back. Don't move your hips, just move your chest. Now shift everything back. Check that your crotch is rounded. As you come back, it's very easy for our front knee to tilt in. Make sure crotch rounded. Back knee, back toe in a line. Okay, forward, back, forward, back, forward, back, forward, back. One more, forward, back, and stand up. And back to where we began. So that's our fundamentals for today. We're just doing four on each side, and you're doing it very gently. If you can do it more than once a week, even if you just do four, gradually you'll find it helps your form everywhere. We'll see a couple of places today where it makes a difference. So today we will be reviewing the Strike Tigers, which is what we learned last week. The new movements, we'll actually be learning two, depending on how time goes. We'll be doing a right heel kick, and then we'll doing twin fists, boxing opponent's ears. But let's practice together first. So we're going to start at the beginning of the first, second section, go all the way to the Strike Tigers. Two things. One is think about those posture things we were practicing and pick one. And as you go through the practice, every once in a while, just check in with your body and see, is my head up or are my shoulders down? The other thing is, if there are any questions when we get to the end of this practice together, feel free, ask anything about any of the movements that we've done. Let us begin. So we're at the beginning of the second section. We're in cross hands. Embrace tiger, return to the mat. Roll back. Press. Push. Transition to fist under elbow. Fist under elbow. Step back, repulse monkey. One. Two. Three. Diagonal flying. Raise hands. Step forward. White crane spreads its wings. Left brush knee. Needle at sea bottom. Fan through the back. Turn body. Chop with fist. Step forward. Parry, block, and punch. Step up. crossbird's tail. Roll back. Press. Push. Transition to single whip. Single whip. Cloud hands. One. Two. Three. Single whip. High pat on horse. Right separation kick transition. Right separation kick. Left separation kick. Transition. Left separation kick. Turn body. Left heel kick. Left brush knee. Right brush knee. Step up, punching down. Turn body. Chop with fist. Step forward. Parry block and punch. Right heel kick. Left strike tiger. Right strike tiger. And stop. Okay. Any insights, observations as you were practicing, things that you noticed that you were doing or were not doing?
Not getting into left striking tiger correctly.
Oh, you did. You
said. No, I didn't get into it. No.
Okay. We'll work on that.
Good.
Yep. That's going to be a focus for today is the strike tigers. Was there anything in particular, Sharon, that you noticed when you were going into left strike tiger? Was it the footwork or the arm movements?
Well, I don't think it was so much the footwork. I think it was the arm movements more, but I was thrown off because of the one, I think it was the arm movements that threw me off. So then my footwork was a little off. So,
okay.
Because I know you've got to step and turn your toe to the corner. But then I was got so into my arms and thinking something's not right here.
Okay.
Then where did my footwork go? So I think I'm trying to analyze it too deeply. I don't know.
Okay, so tell you what, let's quickly review that now. And because we're going to just practice this together again, but rather than having you get stuck a second time, let's just quickly talk about that footwork, and we'll review it again in detail. So, So If you are going the same, if you started off facing the front, you did a right heel kick to the left side, which is the 9 o'clock direction. Now you probably want to turn, because when you do it, then you'll be facing away from the camera. But here's the transition. So we sink and we squat down. The feet are parallel, so both feet are pointing to the corner. The arms don't change as we squat down. Then as we shift our weight to the right, the shift of the weight to the right swings the left arm over to the right, and we step out with the left foot touch with the heel. And then we do the arm movements. So Sharon, my guess is it's that first, after you've touched down with your right heel, the arms coming across. Right, let's just talk about that again briefly and we'll review in detail. So let's see if I'm doing a right, no, I'll do it this direction. Okay, so we've done the heel kick. Squat down, both feet parallel, so both feet pointing to the corner. As you shift your weight to the right arm doesn't change, but the left arm sweeps across horizontally as you step out with the left heel. And your finishing position here is both arms are pointing to the right side. The left leg is pointing off by 90 degrees, in fact, to the back. And you're looking in the direction of your front foot. In other words, the left foot. And then we'll do the arms. We'll review the arms when we do the detail again. That looks nice, Michael. Okay, any other questions at this point? Okay, let us actually just practice together. Actually, let's do... Let's do from the left heel kick. So we've done, after we've done the separation kicks, we've done the kicks, we've done the turns, we are facing to the left side, if I'm not mistaken. And we're going to, no. Yeah, tell you what, let's just start with that right heel kick and do those, do the two strike tigers. So, we're standing on the left leg. We've done a right heel kick. We'll do the strike tigers. I'll talk through the cues and then I'll watch you do it. So one, sink your weight down, both feet parallel. Two, shift the weight to the right. The left arm circles to the right. The left foot steps to the straight direction and you're looking in the direction of your front foot. Swing down both arms, big circle with the left arm, smaller circle with the right arm, finish with a punch. That's left strike tiger. Right strike tiger, shift your weight back onto the right foot, pivot the left heel, 135 degree turn, sit both arms to the left side as you step out with the right foot, bow stance, looking to the front, both arms swing and punch. So let me watch you do that. So just do that a few times on your own pace. That's very helpful. So there's a couple of things that I noticed that we should work on. So the first is when we've done the right heel kick, we're going to sit, touch with the right heel. The left arm is going to come across horizontally. Some of us are bringing the left arm down. It doesn't come down. When you go to the right, the left arm just comes across horizontally. The next thing is there are three things that happen in the second step. So let's just call out what those three things are. So one is squat down. So the first thing that happens is your weight is shifting onto your right leg. The second thing that happens at the same time is that your left arm is coming across. And the third thing that happens at the same time is that you're stepping out with the left foot. So let's just go through those again. One, sit step. Now, shift your weight, swing the left arm, and step out with the left leg. Those three things go together. Do that again, and then we'll go on. So one, squat down. Two, shift the weight, swing the left arm, step out with the left foot. Here, I want you to check that your chest is absorbed. Feel that you have this nice round circle with your left arm, with the left fingertips pointing to the right forearm center, that it's nice and rounded. So it's not close, it's open. The other thing, once we've, so let's start again and we'll keep going to number three. So one, squat out. Two, shift the weight, swing the arms, step out. Three, circle the arms down. So the left arm goes a big circle, the right arm goes a smaller circle, and punch. One of the things again here that I want us to notice is that we have our chest sinking and our back rounded. So it's not this kind of shape, it's this kind of shape. So try and make sure that you show this open shape. Something which is quite tricky to do, but I want you to pay attention to it, is when we finish in this, so we've come here. It's, you remember when we were practicing the bow stance at the beginning, I was saying, imagine parallel lines, front foot, back heel. You want your hip centralized between those two. So you don't want your hip over this side or over this side. For some reason, I don't know why my body does that, but when I do strike tiger, I end up with my hip jutting out here. Make sure that your torso is vertical when you finish in this posture. So when you pause for a moment here, check that your hips are centralized so that everything is vertical. Okay, so what we're going to do now is just do the arm movements the same way we did last week. We're going to do both sides, so it doesn't really matter. I'm going to imagine that I'm mirroring you, so you're facing the screen, you have your right arm out. So it's like in a mirror, so you've got your right arm out. So let's think about what your left arm is going to do. The left arm is going to circle down, come up. I should probably do it this way, you can see more. Circle down, come up, keep the hand open until the last minute when you make a fist. So the left arm is going to make essentially a three-quarter circle. And at the last minute, it's going to make a fist. Your right hand is going to press down. Keep the tiger's mouth until you get to the last minute and then make a fist. So the right arm is just going to press down. So let's add those two arms together. So big circle with your left arm, smaller circle with the right. Now we're going to go to the other side. So drop your left arm out to the side, right arm rounded. And now we're going to do it on this side. So your right arm is going to make a big circle, fist at the last minute. So the right arm, big circle. The left arm is going to come, palm is going to press down until the last minute you make a fist. So we're going to alternate now. So we'll start with your left arm out to the side, right arm rounded. Circle, big circle with the right arm, quarter circle with the left. Both arms to the right. Now, big circle with your left arm, small circle with the right. Drop both arms to the right. Big circle with the left, with the right, small circle with the left. And so try just on your own time, just speed it up. Just feel the swing. Just let your shoulders do the work. So that's the movement. And now the only thing that remains is for us to look at the transition from the left strike tiger to the right strike tiger. Okay, so I'm gonna start in this direction, I think. So I've done my right heel kick. One, sink step. Two, left arm goes across, weight shifts to the right, step out with the left leg, heel touch. Now, as you bend the knees, the arms start circling down. When both arms are sort of about at half mast, foot is flat, keep moving forward, bend knee, strike. Now you're going to turn, shift your weight back onto the right leg, turn the left through 135 degrees, both arms to the left side, step out, circle to here, foot flat, to here, bend knee. Let's start again, and I'll start from this direction this time. Hopefully you'll see better. Okay. Left strike tiger, one, sink. Two, shift weight, left arm across, step out with the left foot. Three, circle both arms, foot flat, arms at about 45 degrees. Keep moving, strike. Now we're going to turn. So one, shift your weight back onto the right. Two, arms don't change. Rotate, left heel pivot 135 degrees. Now, as you put all your weight on the left leg, both arms to the left, step out, heel touch. Now we're going to do the arms. So big circle with the right, smaller with the left, and strike. Again. Now I want you to pay attention to where you're looking. So I will call out the gaze direction and then we'll talk about it if necessary when we've done it. So we've started with a right heel kick. I'm looking in the direction of my right hand. Sink, step, I'm still looking at my right hand. Two, shift the weight, left arm circles, step out. As I step out with the left leg, I look in the direction of my left leg. So now when my both arms are out to the right, I'm looking to the left over my left shoulder. I keep looking to the left as I circle my arms and strike. Now I'm going to turn and my gaze is just going to stay in the same direction as my fists. One, shift the weight all the way back onto the right. Two, pivot on the left heel. Three, sink my weight onto the left, drop the arms, and now I'm looking to the left first, then I look to the right where my right leg is. So now I'm looking at where my opponent's going to be. Circle the arms, foot flattens, they get to 45 degrees, and then strike as they finish knee bends. And stop. Is that making sense? I see some puzzled expressions. But hopefully those are not complete puzzlement. Let me just watch you do that quickly and see how it goes. That's looking pretty good. Just a couple of things. That's one of the things about Tai Chi Chuan is there's always something else. You're doing really well. So the next thing to focus on is the relative position and the shape of the fists. As once you've done the strike, let's say you've done left strike tiger here, as you turn, make sure that your fists stay one over the other. So there's a temptation as we start turning to lose track of where our fists are, so just keep that open shape as we come around to here, and then drop the arms and look and finish. And again here, nice round open shape, fist eye over fist eye. The fists are in the same vertical line, not one forward and one back. Okay. Let us move on. So from here, we're going to do what is really a movement. You know, the transition is, as always, the transitions are interesting, but we're going to do a right heel kick. So we've done, and actually, if I'm going in the same direction as you, let me just do it in the same direction as you. You finished off with a right strike tiger. So you're facing towards the front, 12 o'clock direction. You're going to, with a body turn, open the left heel. As you shift the weight, you're going to block out with the left arm. Then you're going to turn the right toe in, cross the arms, stand up, keep the fists, and punch. So it's a right heel kick at the end. So it's the usual things about heel about kicks. So we make a shallow rainbow with our arms and with palms about shoulder height, maybe a little lower. We keep the fists until we start striking out with the arms. So hold the fists until you open when you strike. When you kick, flex the foot, and it's a stomp kick. So you're actually connecting with the heel. There's 45 degree angle between the direction of your kick and the standing leg. Front arm in the direction of the kicking foot, the back arm is open to the back corner. So those are the standard things with the kicks. Now let's work on the transition. So let me start. Yeah, you can just about see that. We'll do the footwork first. So we finished in a right bow stance. With body turning, we're going to use the turning of the body to turn the left toe open. So turn the left toe from one corner to the other corner. So it's turned through 90 degrees. Most of your weight is still on the right leg. You're going to shift your weight from right to left, and then close the right foot so that it's to the side. Then you're going to stand up and kick. So we'll do the footwork again. You're in a bow stance to the 12 o'clock direction. You're going to end up kicking to the 9 o'clock direction. So with a body turning, use your turning chest, turning hips to open the left toe, but keep your weight on the right leg. Shift your weight forward onto the left leg. Then turn the back toe so that the right toe is to the straight direction. Then stand up and kick. One way to... do I want to go this way? No, I'll go this way. One, your body will tell you if you forget to turn in that right toe, you'll find it very hard to stand up. So let me just show you what I mean. So we've started here. One, with body turning, open the left toe. Two, shift the weight over and turn the left toe in. From here, you're going to stand up. If you've left your right foot back there, your stance is going to be really long. It's going to be really hard to stand up. So the reason you turn your right toe in is to make it easier to stand up and kick. So now let's add the arm movements. So we've done right strike tiger, right bow stance, right arm over the head, left arm punching stomach height. So one is with a body turn, so your fists relative to each other don't move, but your chest is going to turn to open your left toe through 90 degrees. Now you're going to connect out with the left arm. At the same time, your right arm is going to drop. You can't actually see the right arm. I'll do a different angle in a minute. Then you're going to circle the right arm down, stand up, and kick. Let's do it in this direction. Okay, we're in a right bow stance, right arm over the head, left arm in front of the stomach. One, with body turning, open the left toe through 90 degrees. Shifting the weight forward, connect out with the left arm as the right arm comes down. Continue the right arm circling as you close the right toe, cross, stand up, and kick. One thing that I want you to pay attention to is the movement of the right arm. So you're starting with your right arm over the head. This is going to be very much like cloud hands. So it's going to come down and then your elbow is going to rotate. So your palm is going to come from facing forward to facing back. Now it's going to be a fist and then it's going to lift. So I want you to be careful that you don't just come across, don't just shortcut it. Don't come across like this. Come all the way down, make a big circle from up to down and down to up. Let's do that together. We're at right strike tiger, right bow stance, right hand over the head, left fist in front of the stomach. One, with body turning, open the left toe 90 degrees. Two, shift the weight to the left, connect out with the left arm, the right arm starts coming down. Three, turning in the right toe, the right arm keeps circling and you cross. Stand up, flex the foot, open the palms and kick. Again. Right strike tiger, right hand over the head. One, with body turning, open the left toe. Keep your weight on the right hand side. Shifting the weight to the left, connect out with the left arm. Right arm starts coming down. Close the right toe to the straight direction as the right arm circles. Arms are now crossed. Your chest is to the corner over the cross of your arms. Stand up and then kick in the straight direction. Okay. Are there any questions? So I want to show you the second movement we're going to learn today. And then we are going to do the two together. But I'm actually going to ask Susan to come in and help me show you the applications in a minute. But I just want to show you the second movement. So we have done, let's just do it in this direction. So we've done right strike tiger. We do the right heel kick. That's what we've done so far. Now we're going to do twin fist boxing opponent's ears. Turn, both arms come down, both arms punch to the opponent's temple. So that's twin fists. Let me just get Susan. And you guys, Martha. Okay. So first, let's look at the this block and kick that we've done. So Susan is going to come in. So let's say I've done something towards an opponent in front. Susan's going to come and strike. I'm actually going to block out, or connect out with Susan and deflect away. I want to immobilize this arm, so that's going to, I'm going to swing my right arm down, so her arm is now immobilized. I can now stand up and stomp on her foot or kick her belly or something. So essentially, so let's do that again. So I'm going to connect out, circle up and immobilize, and kick. The second movement, which is the one that we I think this is a good one. So actually, let's just do it straight first. This is yet another of the many times when an opponent in Tai Chi Chuan comes for you with two arms. And so what Susan's going to do is come to me with two arms. I'm going to deflect down, make sure that my hands stay on the inside of her arms, and strike to her head. And so if, yes, we do it here, you can see a little bit better. I'm going to deflect down, rotate, and strike. One of the things that I'll be talking about is the rotation of the fists here in punching through the opponent's ears. And the reason we do this is so that we maintain contact with our opponent's arms. So for example, if Susan comes in and I just do this, suddenly she can punch. So I need to make sure that when I'm deflecting down, I'm staying in contact with her and with my hands on the inside of her hands the whole time so that I control the punch. Thank you. Okay, so let's do twin fists. We have done a right heel kick. And there's a turn in this one. And so let's pay attention to the turn and the step. So I'm starting with my left foot, my weight's on my left leg. I've done a right heel kick. My left toe is to the corner. I'm going to do a bow stance to the other corner. So I need to turn my left foot from this position to this position. So I have to rotate my left leg, standing leg, through 45 degrees. The way I do that is by turning my upper body and my right hip, my right leg first, and close my left foot. So now my left foot is to the straight direction. Then from here, I'm going to step out into a bow stance. And that's pretty straightforward. So again, the footwork is we're going to start with the left toe to the corner, open the right knee to the other corner, close your hip to bring your left foot around, step out into a bow stance. One of the reasons why I'm belaboring this thing about using your right, opening your right hip, which in fact is turning your whole body, and then bringing the toe across, is that where most of us start when we first do this is we try and do the turn starting with our feet. So if you try and start with your feet, you end up like doing these kind of hop movements. It's much easier if you open your right hip and then just close the hip to bring the left foot around. And then, you know, you can practice this yourself, but you can actually, you can do this more or less indefinitely. You know, you've got a lot of control because you're just closing your hip, not essentially trying to jump and do a turn. Now we're going to practice the arm movements and then we'll put the two of them together. The arm movements are symmetrical. We're going to start with our arms. We've done a kick. The arms are going to come to the front, shoulder height, shoulder width apart. You're going to deflect down so that your forearms are on top of the opponent's arms. Palms come to in front of the hips. Then you're going to make a circle with the arms and the fists, and then punch up. So there's a couple of things. Let's do it slowly first, and then we'll do it quickly, and it'll be much easier. The first thing I want you to notice is when we bring our arms down, remember, we want to keep our chest sinking and our back rounded. So we don't want to just take our elbows straight back, because if I come down with my hands to my hips with my elbows behind me, you can see my back is no longer rounded. What I have to do is to actually rotate my elbows out as my arms come down. So as my arms come down, my elbows come out. So from this angle, arms come down, elbows go out. Now, from here, you're going to make a fist, rotate the whole arm, and sit the fists. So essentially, I'll try and get up close here. So what's happening is that I'm making a circle with my elbows. It's not a wrist circle. It's a whole arm circle. But I like to think about it, if I imagine my fist, it's painting a nice circle. It's actually going in a circle. And when I finish, you can see my wrists are what we call sitting, so there's a slight flex in my wrist. So let's do that bit together. Arms straight ahead, drop them down as they come to the hips, elbows out to the side. Keep moving with the circle, rotate the fists, sit the fists. Again, drop the arms, make a fist, rotate, and sit. Now we're going to finish that big circle, down, make a fist, round, and then all the way out. Michael knows this bit. He was doing this bit. When you finish, the energy point is the crown of the fist. So it's this knuckle here. And we say punching opponents' ears. It's actually not their ears. It's the temple. Not very thin bone in the temple. That's why you're hitting it with the crown of the fist. So you're aiming for your own temple height. And it's not like this. It's like this. So not like this, but like this. So now, yes, exactly like that, Michael. Yep. So let's do this just quickly a couple of times on your own time. Swing down, make a circle at the bottom, and swing up. Down, circle, and swing up. Down, circle, and swing up. And in terms of method, these essential principles, remember what we were practicing at the beginning of class? One of them was shoulders down. So here, this is a place where you really want to make sure you've got your shoulders down, because it's so easy to end up with our shoulders up. We want to be shoulders down, elbows down when we finish. Okay. So we're not going to worry about the turn yet. Let's just put the arms together. So we've done the right heel kick. We're going to turn the left toe, just step it around, and we're going to end up with our right knee and our arms pointing towards the corner. We're going to sink, rotate the arms, step out, and do a bow stance to the corner. Again, so we're starting facing the side, left toe to the corner. We've done the kick. We're going to just step the left, close the left heel, the arms close. So when your left foot is in line with the side, your arms are pointing to the corner. Then as they sink, you're going to do a bow step to the corner. The last thing we need to pay attention to here for now is the coordination. So where is the upper body and where is the lower body? So let us do everything together. So we've done the right heel kick. One, pivot on the left heel. So you're looking at the corner, both arms to the corner. Sink, step. When you're palms get to the hips, you're touching with the heel. As you do the first part of the circle to here, you're flattening the foot. The knee hasn't bent yet. As you strike up to the temples, bend knee. Again, start having done the right heel kick. Open the right leg, close the left foot, arms and right knee to the corner. Sink. When the palms are making fists by the hips, heel touch with the right foot. As you flatten the right foot, you make that circle at the bottom, palms sitting. As you bend your knee, punch up. One more. One, turn both arms to the corner. Two, sink, step out, make fist. Three, rotate circle at the bottom, foot flat. Four, bend knee, striking out. The last thing I will throw in here, I'm throwing a lot at you today. Only remember what you remember, doesn't matter. You'll hear it again from somebody else. Is remember the waist practice that we did at the beginning of class? We were doing forward and back, right? Forward and back. We actually use this forward and back when we do this strike. So actually what's happening here is as I come down, my waist is going back, and as I'm striking forward, it's the movement of my waist and my chest forwards that's actually moving my arms. So the waist is leading the limbs. It's actually as I come back, I've got a backward movement with the waist. As I strike forward, it's a forward movement with the waist. So to finish, let us do left strike tiger, right strike tiger, right heel kick, punch to the ears. So let us begin. We've done right heel kick going to the left-hand side, 9 o'clock direction. We're going to do right strike tiger. One, sink. Two, shift the weight to the right, left arm goes to the right, and step the left foot to the back. Three, circle the arms, foot flat, finish your strike, bend knee. Right strike tiger. One, shift weight back. Two, pivot the left foot, 135 degrees, hands don't change. Three, sink onto the left leg, both arms to the left, step out with the right foot, look to the front. Four, circle the arms and strike. Right heel kick. With body turning, open the left toe through 90 degrees. Shifting the weight to the left, connect out with the left arm, right arm starts going down. As the right arm circles up, close the right foot, stand up, and right heel kick. Twin fists, boxing opponent's ears. One, turn the right leg to the corner, bring your left foot across. Both arms are pointing to the corner. Two, sink. Heel touch, hands by the hips, making a fist. Three, rotate as the foot flattens. Fist sitting. Four, strike to opponent's temple. And stop. We'll stop there for today. We'll review next week. If there are any questions, just stay on after class and we can talk about them. But let us finish here. Thank you, Chairman. 再见.
老师再见。